one of our six key strategic initiatives over the next 5 years is culture. And the Organizational Development Unit, which is the a part of Human Resources, is the department in which I support. But our role specifically, we drive culture through leadership development initiatives, talent development initiatives, as well as general professional development. So we ensure that we have a proper onboarding and orientation process. We have e-learning modules, we have video blogs, we have infographics, we have interactive brochures that we typically take advantage of specifically for our store associates. Now, the store culture is a little bit different because we have sales associates who are driven by commission. And so most of the e-learning modules that we create for that particular audience has to be done within a 3 to 5 minute period. So we have to be very succinct in our message. We have to ensure that any content that we're developing is exclusive to that particular audience, and it's going to help them be able to sell products more. Measurement is huge. It is something in just the learning and development space that can be pretty difficult if you don't jump on it, you know, up front. But our recent team and our recent learning and development strategy has caused us to go all the way back to Kirkpatrick and say, hey, what are we doing at each level of evaluation to ensure that this training is actually going to transfer on the job? And so we measure things like retention. We measure all of the big KPIs that the organization is looking for, items per transaction, pro coverage attachment rate, sales, of course, year over year comparison, and things like that. Guitar Center, as an enterprise, we have a slogan. It's called Find Your Sound. And it is something that we use within the stores to get customers to feel comfortable with using our products. And it aligns closely with leadership branding, right? So what's your brand? What's your sound? How do you want to be recognized throughout the organization? And we spend a lot of time talking about leadership branding specifically because we realize that leaders are an effective leader is evaluated on their IQ, their intellectual quotient, their EQ, their emotional quotient, and their AQ, their adaptability quotient. And so we look for those principles even at the start of a recruitment process when we're looking to promote internally. We look for those three particular characteristics. And so this finding your sound coupled with this whole leadership branding concept with leading simply has really begun to do something within our culture. It's caused associates who are sometimes complacent or who've gotten very, very comfortable in their roles to sort of step their game up in terms of learning and development because they realize that we have a lot of subject matter experts who are coming into the organization who knows retail, who knows sales, who knows leadership. And so all of those factors together have really kind of helped shape the culture and where we're going moving forward.